Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, I'll be showing you what are the new things that has been added to the Laravel version 8.61.0. It had just been released yesterday, and I'll be showing you three things that has been added to this specific version. The first thing that has been added is --- policy flag on the PHP artisan make model command. So if I show you here, adds a policy option in the make model command. Basically, we can just say PHP artisan make model school, and we can say policy like this, and now it will automatically create a policy for that school. So if I just hit enter, the model has been created and the policy has also been created. And if you look at the files changed over here, you can see here the school model is created over here. It looks like this, and school policy is created over here. So let me now just remove this. And whenever we write --- all flag, then also this policy will get included. So now instead of passing --- policy flag, if we pass this --- all flag, then it will create model, factory, migration, seeder, controller, and now it will also create a policy. You can see the list of all the files that have been created. This composer, JSON, and web.php files, these were modified by me before, so these are also showing here, but the files that have been created were from here to here. This is the one thing. Now next thing that has been added is this deleteOrFail method. Before, in the earlier versions of Laravel, saveOrFail and updateOrFail method were added, so now deleteOrFail method is also added. And if you look here in the files changed over here, so following things have been changed. If the model does not exist, it will just return false, and if the delete fails, then it will throw an exception. And the third thing is added to the testing, which is a method called assertExists. Before, in the test, let's say we created a product, then we can test it like this. The assert database has the products, the table name, and if that ID exists in that table or not. But now we can just do this. We can say here this assert exists, and we can pass the model. But there is one another way that is mentioned by the Taylor Otwell, the creator of Laravel himself, in here in the comment section. We can also do it like this, but it is more readable, guys. We don't have to remember there is exist property in the model or not. We can just say here if the model exists, then the assertion will pass, otherwise it will fail.